The Orbital Sciences Corporation test flight of the Antares rocket will be carrying a very small secondary payload into space. On board are three nanosatellites that were designed and built at NASA Ames Research Center, the lead center for small spacecraft development. Two of the CubeSats are called PhoneSat 1, and one of them is a PhoneSat 2 beta.
Someone here asked the question, can we fly a cell phone as the avionics for a satellite and have something that's very capable but really, really inexpensive? So PhoneSat was launched to try to answer that question.
Measuring only 4 inches on each side and weighing less than 4 pounds, each miniaturized satellite was built for only $3,500 each and will showcase the ability to launch the lowest cost, easiest to build satellite ever flown in space. The design makes extensive use of commercial off-the-shelf components, including a consumer-grade smartphone. Out-of-the-box smartphones offer capabilities needed for satellites, including fast processors, versatile operating systems, multiple miniature sensors, high-resolution cameras, GPS receivers, and several radios.
The smartphone vendors have put a lot of R&D money into making very, very capable microprocessors that have a lot of processing power and speed in a package that's very rugged. And we intend to fly it as a microprocessor for a satellite.
NASA's PhoneSat 1.0 is built around the Nexus 1 smartphone, while PhoneSat 2.0 beta has improved software and more sensors. Upon deployment into space, each satellite will broadcast a signal every 30 seconds on the amateur UHF band at 437.425 MHz. The PhoneSat project will be a success if NASA confirms reception of signals from the CubeSats. However, anyone around the world can listen for this signal and upload what they hear to www.phonesat.org.